If you're building a house, the nature of the bricks and their constitution will determine to a certain extent what height of wall you can build, but it won't determine the plan of the house. That requires an information input from an architect. Once the houses are built, they will determine to a certain extent how many of them you can put in a street, but it won't determine the plan of the town. There's a hierarchy where there's top-down causation involved, because you need an informational input. So one of the key questions faced by modern biology is, where do you get information from? Having tried now for 53 years or so to prove that matter plus energy plus time plus chance and the laws of nature generate information seems to be running into the sand. Perhaps the time has come to mount a simultaneous attempt to show scientifically that you cannot generate information through natural processes.
You have some text in front of you. Okay, there are laws of physics and chemistry that apply to how that ink or toner got applied to that paper. But those laws of physics and chemistry do not tell you how that ink got organized to form meaningful text. I mean, you're never going to get that out of the laws of physics and chemistry. And I would say, likewise, we would say, try to understand biology in material terms, and there's going to be something missing. There are going to be patterns and organizations there which you cannot account for in terms of just brute material processes. You're going to need some sort of mind, intelligence, purposiveness that has to be brought into the mix if this is going to work at all. I mean, if life were very simple, if you looked inside the cell and all you saw were little blobs floating around and it was just, these were just blobs of jello, you know, it could easily have originated by some form of spontaneous generation, a little pond with lightning flashing. But that's not what the cell is. The cell is the most complicated thing that we find, and it's not just brute complexity. It's that we've got this whole automated city. Everything is automated, it's a level of nanotechnology which would cause any engineer to drool.
Well, isn't that exactly what evolution is about? It says that the inside of the cell evolved over 4.5 billion years, and 4.5 billion years is a lot of time.
Well, deep time is only going to purchase you so much. I mean, if you take all the chance in the universe and you try to set all the monkeys in the universe typing at a typewriter, the most you're going to get out of Shakespeare is the first two lines of Hamlet's soliloquy. Chance by itself can't get you very far.